hard of the class?
The most difficult.
Well, for me, I think other than having to do the projects, it was probably keeping in touch with the whole group. Definitely, it's very important.
Yeah, probably keeping in touch with the group and staying in touch with everyone.
Yeah, I think if we're going off everything, it would probably be learning to expand yourself when you're within the team, because a lot of times you like shrink down and only work as your own part instead of like working as an assembly line. And I think that was fun to like work together rather than working as individuals.
Yeah, I definitely say try to keep it fresh. Try to make sure that you're rotating around in roles and that you understand each role, so that way it's a little bit, you know, more fun and everyone's on the same track.
So how important is teamwork in this class and why?
Extremely. You are not ever doing anything by yourself. I think there's maybe like two assignments other than the quizzes at the end that we have to turn in by ourselves.
Spoiler. Yeah, every grade in this class is based on teamwork basically, so keep in touch with your team. Do it. So, what did you learn from each of the projects?
For half of the course, it's mainly just staying on like one thing. So, you'll notice that the more that you have in your group, it's kind of harder to make sure everyone has a role, especially when into the second half of the course, you're mainly just going to be doing coding and document writing, maybe a little bit of designing here and there, just switching values. So,
and when you get later into the course, then we start doing programming. So, learning how to code in MATLAB is different from Java and it's different from C++, so it's a bit of a learning curve, but that's kind of fun.
And on top of that, like, what you learn is that when you're working with technology, a lot of the time you cannot rely on everything to be like completely 100% perfect. Like, a lot of these robots that you'll work with are going to be pretty messed up and you have to work around them. That's how engineers have to work with like old technology to make it feel modern, I guess.
What did we individually take away from the class?
I don't know, I just can't really stress enough how important it is to just make sure that you have good bonds and you can be able to understand the roles of other people by, you know, swapping it around. Like, say if one person's good at coding, the other person's good at designing, maybe just like having exchanges back and forth of why and how like things are the way they are. But yeah, it's mainly just communication, you know, being able to work as a team is a really important skill.
And another thing that I would like learn in this class was if everybody in the team puts in like a good part, that often you don't feel as stressed as like you usually do in the group. Like, the groups here were pretty great. It's way different than high school, but it's not the slackers.
Yeah, if each member gets everything done, it can basically just be completed in a day and you'll get a lot of progress done. Whereas like, say, you know, my chemistry lab class, communication probably isn't as good, and holding each other accountable may not happen as often in like other classes, whereas in this class, if you hold people accountable, oftentimes you'll find everything's done basically on the same day as your lab.
Yeah, my biggest takeaway would be that teams can actually be good in classes. You definitely have to hold everybody accountable, which is something that doesn't seem to happen very often in other classes. But here you'll notice it's very much emphasized, and everything depends on it. You'll be reminded of it, and it's very true. So what changes would we make?
I'd like it not to be as stressed as much on just repeating the same thing over and over, like in the second half. I think finding some other new stuff, like I really liked the first half of the course because it's just all like, all right, whose role is this going to be to? All right, we need to find a new role for this person. And I thought that was kind of good, whereas after into the second half, the roles were just kind of like defined as basically just refining things a little bit more. Whereas, you know, just before it was fresh.
I think some changes that I would make would be a lot more progress in like terms of building the robot. Like it seemed like the first 70% of building the robot was like nothing, but then like towards the end, we were like cramming to get stuff on the maze and like things working in the code. I think if you open it up with more relating to the robot and like allow students to like, build the robot in the first half and code for the robot in the second half, maybe like we get a lot better results.
I think really the only change I would push for is we worked on the robot for a long time, but then we only ran it once for our final score, and we may or may not have had a small disaster.
The person did die.
Not that bad. So I would have loved the second chance at running our final project again, but overall I enjoyed the class.
Maybe like different, you know, mazes or something.
Yeah.
Change it up. Maybe like a level 1, level 2 type of thing. So we could get some more chances than just the one.
Yeah, like different functions or stuff like that.
Something like that.
Yeah, that would be nice.
So what obstacles did we face as individuals and as a team, and what did we do to overcome them?
I don't know about individually, but I'd have to say as a team, we were mainly just trying to, we basically had the design set down, but overcoming the errors and basically the technology given to us was fairly difficult trying to figure that out. And there wasn't really much more to do about it than just change around a couple of numbers and see what worked.
We started out with 4 people, and then we got down to 3. A lot of groups had like 5 or 6, but that wasn't like too bad. I feel like it helps us a lot to like have smaller groups as you learn in your PowerPoints. Small groups are more efficient. And then as an individual, I think it's hard to communicate as much as you like you're used to.
For me, as an individual, I mean, just as a freshman here at ASU, managing all my classes, which included this one, could be difficult, but it was fine. It was fine in the end. It just, you know, takes a couple of weeks, and then you're into the groove. As a team, I echo everything that you guys said. We had code problems. MATLAB could be a little wonky sometimes. You know, we had to work with a smaller group, which was good in the end, but it was kind of hard at first. Overall, we overcame all the challenges, I think, that we had. And we ended up as a good group. We really were. So, what advice would we give to new students?
Definitely take the time to go over the weekend or just find some extra time that where you can be able to go into the lab and try to adjust your values to make them perfect, make sure the robot runs the functions that you currently have perfectly, and after, you know, implementing, say, a new function, make sure that runs perfectly and all the other ones run perfectly after having that thing implemented. to say, don't stress out too much. This is a fairly relaxed class. If you manage to, you know, get the skills of teamwork and holding each other accountable, it's basically just a nice breeze class, I have to say.
My advice would be to really pay attention to his PowerPoints, because he's got a lot of good stuff to say in there. And really, like, some of the things you'll find, like, you'll think that are the most pointless things. Like, we did a class about salt shakers that eventually, like, helped us realize that we have to be innovative, that, like, they were designed for our robots. And, like, no robot was the same after doing that salt shaker. Like, everybody had different robots. We learned creativity and, like, how to work with design and engineering in order to, like, make a product that's both, like, new and compatible.
Yeah, the lectures are really nice.
My advice would be show up to class, show up to labs especially, because it's part of your grade, and also everybody needs you to be there to do stuff. I would recommend, when you have questions, ask Steve. He's more than willing to help
ask
you.
Ask about Java.
Yeah. You can ask him about other classes too, which we kind of did. He's very helpful.